Hello viewers, welcome back. In this video, we are going to see how to connect our Python application with Xampp MySQL server. Python can be connected with MySQL database. This connection is performed through an interface called Python MySQL connector. Here we have this Python application which has extension .py, your coding part, and here is the Xampp server MySQL database. So we want to access the data from the MySQL database, and it can perform crude operations, create, read, update and delete. All these operations can be done with the database using this Python application. But we need an interface to connect our Python application with MySQL. This interface is called MySQL Python connector. A connection request is sent from Python application to this MySQL Python connector, and connection is established. Based on the queries executed here, the result will be sent back from the MySQL database to this Python MySQL connector. MySQL connector Python is written in pure Python, and it is useful for executing database queries in Python, and it is an official Oracle supported self-contained driver. This self-contained driver means that it does not require any other Python modules outside the standard library. Just by installing this MySQL connector Python, we can perform all the required operations with the database, and it is Python 3 compatible too. The first step in connecting Python code to the MySQL is that we have to install this MySQL connector Python using this command. You have to use pip install mysql-connector-python, and you will get a set of messages like this, and finally the message will be successfully installed MySQL connector Python and the version name. After installing MySQL connector Python, you can just directly go for the coding part in our Python application. The first step is you have to import this mysql.connector module. Next is you have to create an object called as connection. This connection is done using this connect method of mysql.connector, which will establish a connection between the Python application and the MySQL database. After the connection is established, the cursor object should be created. Cursor object is useful for reading data from the database as well as writing data to the database. You can perform all operations using this cursor object, and it is bound to the connection for its entire lifetime. It can be viewed as a pointer to one row in a set of rows, and it enables sequential processing of all the rows in a result set. After creating the connection, you can interact with the database by executing the queries. After executing all the queries, you can close the connection. Now let's start writing our Python code to connect to our database. Let me start. I will just first import MySQL connector. And connection must be established now. The next step is we have to create the connection object using this mysql.connector. mysql.connector.connect method, and you have to pass four arguments here: the host to be connected, the username, password and the database which you are going to use. The host name is localhost. Username is the username which you are going to give to connect to your Xampp server, and the password and the database name. So let's check what database to use. Make sure your Xampp server is running. I'm starting the Xampp server. By default, this MySQL server runs in the port number 3306. In some cases, people might have changed their port number to some other number. I have changed the port number here. So if you have changed the default port number, it must be mentioned explicitly while connecting. So I am just including the port number also. Port number 3307 and database name. Localhost php myadmin. I have this collection of database. Let me see this hospital database. I'll just try to list out all the doctors' details from hospital database. So I'll make use of the database hospital DB. Okay, now fine, the connection is established. The next thing is we have to create the cursor object. Cursor is equal to connection dot cursor. Now let me write the query. It's going to be a single select query. Select star from doctor table. After selecting all rows from the doctor, now I can execute this query by using cursor.execute of this select query. Okay, and I can fetch all the records using cursor.fetchAll. This fetchAll method is going to fetch all the rows in the record set, and we can find out the total number of records. In this case, it's going to be the number of doctors. Number of doctors in the hospital can be retrieved by using cursor.rowCount, which will return an integer that specifies the number of rows returned. Now let's retrieve all the details of the doctor using a for loop. For row in records, I'm going to print all the details. Let me check what are the details to be from the doctor table. So we have doctor ID, name, for the name, email, contact. We have almost 10 fields here. We'll just concentrate on few things alone. Doctor ID is present in row of 0, doctor name, row of 3 email, row of 4 contact number, and row of 5 qualifications. We will just print all these things. So first print statement is doctor ID row of 0. The next print statement is doctor name from a row of 1, and then we have this email details which is present in row of 3, contact number in row of 4, and finally the qualifications from row of 5. So we have printed all the details. Now I will include an empty print statement so that after printing each and every doctor's details, we will have a new line. Now we close the cursor first. Cursor.close and then connection.close. The connection is closed now. Make sure your exam server is running before executing this Python application. So if everything is fine, we can execute and we got the result. So we have totally 5 records. So number of doctors in the hospital 5 is displayed, doctor ID and her details, doctor ID 2, 3, 4 and 5. All the details are displayed in the Python console. So this is how you can connect our Python application to the database just by simply making use of this Python MySQL connector. The same output can also be displayed in the browser since we are making use of this exam server. We have to make some changes to our Python applications and in the settings. Then we can see the output in the browser. We'll see that now. So let's see the steps to be implemented to display the same output in the browser. The first thing is you have to find the Xampp directory where you have installed it. Usually it will be installed in C:. Go to Xampp folder and then find out the configuration folder. From Xampp you have to go to Apache folder. In Apache folder you have this configuration folder conf. In conf we have this httpd.configuration file. You can open it with any text editor and edit it. I am just opening it with a notepad. And you have to go to the end of the file. Go to the end of the file and add these two lines. Add handler cgscript.py and script interpreter source registry strict. These two lines should be added. After adding, just press Ctrl F and just type if module dir underscore module and find out the location where it is placed. After finding out, you have a list of extensions here, and the last one will be home.htm. After that, leave a space and give index.py. So index.py must be added at the end inside this if module dir underscore module. After doing these changes, just save it and close it. So that's it. Now you have to restart Xampp server if it is running. Have restarted Xampp server. Now our Python application must be placed in the htdocs in Xampp directory. Only then the output can be seen in the browser. So make sure it is placed in htdocs. Go to Xampp htdocs and have placed the file. In this case, it is text connection .py. I have placed it here. The next step is that you have to include two lines. This line, hash symbol and exclamation symbol, and you have to mention the path of the Python where it is installed /python.exe. So this line is called shebang line. It indicates which interpreter should process the file. So it means Python interpreter should process this file. So for that purpose, this shebang line is used. After the shebang line, you have to print the content type as text/html so that it accepts a HTML. So for the same coding, you have to just include this shebang line. The Python path and python.exe is mentioned, and then this print statement content type text/html. All the remaining things are same. Instead of giving /n new line, I have used break tag br tag from the HTML so that it includes a new line. All the remaining things are same. Now you can go to the browser and type localhost/test connection, your file name with the py extension. You can just run it directly from the browser, and here you can see all the details. That's it. So in this way we can connect our Python application to the Xampp server MySQL database, and it can view the output in the Python console as well as in the browser. Thanks for watching.